Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Today I am going to share with you how I make this lemony alkaline juice recipe. Juicing is the main tool that I used to heal naturally from all the symptoms I was having from fibroids, PCOS, any of the female reproductive issues that I've struggled with. Juicing is the thing that I think was most monumental in helping me to heal naturally. Juicing is not always the most convenient thing to do, but it will give you more bang for your buck. This is just one of many recipes that I have used over the years. If you would like to know more about the recipes that I used, I created an ebook with over 30 juice recipes specifically designed to help with women's health issues. The link is down in the description box, or you can see it above in the links in the video. If you want to see how I made this recipe, then stay tuned. So I'm not going to waste your time with letting you watch me chop all of these vegetables, but I want to just say to chop the vegetables the way you need to chop them for them to fit in your juicer. And I always get the question, what kind of juicer should I use? Of course, my favorite is Green Star, but buy the juicer you can afford and the juicer that you're going to use. I will put some recommendations down below in this description box, but technically, if you get the juice in your body, that's going to be the best thing. So we're going to start off with two. I buy the celery hearts, and usually I buy them from Costco, the organic celery hearts. And they are about six of them in a container, and it's like $3 at my Costco. I have two heads of romaine hearts as well. And I also buy my romaine hearts from Costco, and it's there's like eight of them in there, and I don't remember how much they cost, but I buy them in bulk. Also, this is about five packed cups of mixed greens. You can use whatever mixed greens you want. You can use spinach, you can use chard, you can use whatever you've got. I just pulled whatever I had out of the refrigerator and used for this recipe, just as long as it's green and it has chlorophyll. The next thing I added was four lemons, and I peeled them. You don't have to peel the lemons if the lemons are organic. As a matter of fact, there's some nutrients in the skin that would be beneficial. The next thing that I used was one large English cucumber. And you can use more than one, but this is really good for this recipe because it's good for the skin and it's good for hydration. So there you have it. That's what I used for this recipe. Also, I'm going to list the ingredients below so you have exactly what is called for in this recipe. One thing that I think is important for juicing is to have a system. So here on the right side, I have my bowl of vegetables that are already chopped. I have my juicer. I have my juice collector, and then I have my garbage collector as far as where I'm putting my pulp. So this helps with easy cleanup and just to get it done quickly. So this is my setup, and so what I do is run all of my vegetables produce through the juicer, and when I'm done, I dump the pulp. I might save it for crackers or something like that, but most of the time I throw it away. I don't worry about all the fiber. A lot of people get caught up in the fiber. I don't get caught up in that. I collect the juice here, and I also do one other thing. I have a pitcher, which I don't have here right at the moment, and I'm not sure why. I use my Vitamix mix pitcher with the strainer on top just to strain the juice one more time. Not that this juice is really pulpy when it comes through this juicer, because it's not. But I like my juice to be really, really smooth. But you see that? That's where the juice has come through, and there's the pulp in there. And now, let me see if I have it to show you. I'm not sure if I've videoed it. Looks like I didn't, unfortunately. But what I typically do is just run my juice through the strainer and make it nice and smooth and ready for adding it to my storage containers. And I always store my juice in glass, never plastic, always store in glass. And these are just leftover juice containers from store-bought juice. That's all this is. Or I'll use mason jars, as you guys have seen me use in the past. But there you have it, y'all. Juicing is life-saving, in my opinion. I think that overall it has saved my life because I was on my way out of here if I didn't make a change. Juicing is like a miracle. It helps with so many different things, from diabetes to high blood pressure to inflammation in the body to menstrual cramps to, I mean, you name it. And I can go on and on and on. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all, take care.